Hi everyone and welcome back to my channel. So today in this video, we're going to be doing a tutorial on Tradestation. We'll be covering a walkthrough of how to sign up for an account, how to fund the account, how to set up the account, and how to connect to TradingView, and especially to Malaysian investors who are interested in US stocks and also on Tradestation brokerage. Today's video is relevant for you also. So I presume you already have some knowledge and done your research on the commissions, the pricings, and the fees and charges when it comes to Tradestation brokerage. And now you want to make the first move and step to sign up for an account. Anyway, if you haven't, you can still subscribe to this channel to stay tuned for a future video where I'll cover in-depth review on Tradestation and why I chose Tradestation. Before we continue, I want to clarify and not to be confused, there's two Tradestation. There's Tradestation itself, and then there's Tradestation International, or also known as Tradestation Global. So this tutorial video you're watching now is on Tradestation itself. So in the Tradestation homepage, we can open an account as an individual or business. Again, to clarify, today's tutorial will be on opening an individual account. So click the Open Account button on the top right here, and then in the next screen, so we are a new user, click Sign Up. So as we see here in this application, there are six sections which we see on the top here. Account Setup, Personal Information, Employment Information, Financials and Experience, Summary and Agreements, and Finish. Starting with Account Setup, fill out the customer profile, first name, last name, country of residence, state or province, email address, mobile number, and of course, how did you hear about us, Tradestation. For non-US residents, that means if you are from like Malaysia, follow the name in your government issued ID, like your passport. Then create your login credentials, username and password. Then in the next part under configure your account, under account type here, you can open an individual, join, or business or trust account. In this video, we are opening an individual account. Then select further what accounts to open. There's crypto, equities and options, futures and futures options. If you want to buy and sell shares every now and then, you can opt for the equities and options. If you want to be more aggressive or feel you have more experience or increase your exposure, whichever that floats your boat, you can select any of the accounts or all of the accounts that you want to open. Since I want to and I'm going to open all the accounts, I'm going to select all four accounts. Then next is equity account setting. If you selected equity and option, by default, it is a cash account. If you want to enable margin trading and or options trading, select any or both of them. If you're not sure what is margin trading, click the question tooltip for a pop-up explanation. Since I want to learn and eventually try trading futures, I'm going to enable margin trading. Then on investment risk tolerance, slide to whether you're looking to trade for income, growth, or speculation. Then if you have opted to enable options trading, there's the options trading level. Slide to the level at which you feel you want to trade options. So level 1, you can sell covered calls and protective puts. In level 2 and above, you can do more in options trading. So slide to any level you want to apply for in options trading. Then click next to personal information. Here, fill in your identity, country of citizenship, date of birth, and residential address. Then click next to employment information. So here, firstly, let's fill out the employment status. That means whether you are employed, self-employed, retired, and other employment categories. Then under affiliations, there are three questions that we need to answer. Are you or your spouse associated with or employed by a NYSE, FINRA, and or NFA registered brokerage firm? Are you a director, 10% shareholder, or policy making officer of a publicly owned company? For the purpose of exchange fees, are you deemed a professional subscriber by the exchanges and therefore required to pay higher exchange fees? Since I'm none of these, I'll just select no, no, no for all three. Then click next to financials and trading experience. So there are two subsections here, financials and trading experience. Under financials, select your approximate annual income, approximate total net worth, approximate liquid net worth, what is your source of income, and how will you fund your account. Note that these are to be quoted and then converted into US dollar. This is for my Malaysian applicants and investors. And I know it's $470 per dollar. Then under trading experience, select the years of experience. Since I selected options and futures earlier, I have to indicate my years of experience in them also. Then click next to summary and agreement. In this extra part, would you like to provide us, TradeStation, with contact information for a trusted contact person age 18 or older? Well, it's up to you, but for me, I'm going to go with no. I'm not going to provide a person age 18 and older contact information. Then click next to upload in documents. So you have to upload proof of identity and proof of address. For proof of identity, it can be your passport or driver license or ID card, like your NRIC for my Malaysian applicants and investors. So I'm going to upload my driver's license, since I have to upload both front and back of the driver's license. Then proof of address, you have to upload copy of your last utility bill or bank statement. This is for verification of your address of residence. For Malaysian applicants, if you don't have a utility bill, like your TNB or Selangor bill or Unify bill, you can upload your bank statement. And the bank statement has to be the latest within the last 90 days. Then click next to account summary. Then next to account agreement. Here, check the relevant boxes. Since I opted to open a crypto account, I have to also check this box. If you want to read for more information on the agreements, disclosures, disclaimers, and assumptions of risk, you can click and go to the individual link, the individual blue link. Then after checking the boxes, scroll down to primary account holder, double check the account holder name and date of application, then click submit. Then you'll be brought to the next section, deposit funds. Here you'll see your account numbers. Each account has its own account number. Equities has its own account number. Futures has its own account number. Crypto has its own account number. So before depositing funds, I suggest you write down or screenshot your account numbers this page for future reference, which we'll go through on why and what about it later. So before continuing further, you'll receive an email that your application is being processed and TradeStation will email you as soon as the account is approved, which on average takes 3 business days. Then when your TradeStation account has been approved, you'll receive an email on steps on how to fund your account. You can click the link in your email or log in to your TradeStation account. Even though your account has been approved, and then you can also log in, but then you can't place any trade yet, as your account has not been funded. So to fund your account, in your account, go to transfer funds, then go to transfer cash. There are a few ways to transfer cash, or in other words, to deposit funds into your account. There's smart transfer, wire transfer, or by check. So let's look at smart transfer. It is to transfer cash to or from your link US bank account. You need to have a US bank account to use this transfer method. If you have not linked a bank account, select plus add an account. TradeStation uses Plaid, a US-based technology provider, to link your US bank account so that you can easily transfer funds between your TradeStation account and bank. The transfers are processed via the automated clearinghouse ACH network. Then continue to add external account and link your US bank account. Since I don't have a US bank account, I'll have to do a wire transfer, which is to wire cash to your TradeStation account from an external account. So select deposit as direction, then add funds destination, select the account you want to wire money into. And remember I mentioned earlier to save your account numbers for reference. Here you need it. Equities has its own account, futures and futures options have their own accounts as well. And as you see here, I've already also deposited $10 into the account earlier, so I'm going to show you the steps again. Anyway, key in the amount in US dollar you expect to receive or you want to receive in your TradeStation account, then click View Instructions. In the next page here, save this information or you can print this information by clicking here to save the transfer instruction or transfer advice in your computer. Now, since I'm applying from Malaysia, and if you are in Malaysia also, you can do a wire transfer from your bank account. So I use my Maybank account to do the wire transfer, which I'll walk you through now. So in Maybank to you, after you have logged in to your Maybank account, go to Pay and Transfer, then go to Transfer. Select the account that you want to transfer from, then add Transfer to, select Overseas. Then add New Transfer, search for United States. Then referring back to the transfer instruction and advice that we saved earlier or downloaded and printed in our computer. In Maybank to you, under United States, we have to search for the state also. So search and add the state, Florida. Then enter the amount you want to transfer and then click compare. So let's say you want to transfer 10 ringgit, 100 ringgit, 1000 ringgit or whatever amount that you want to transfer. Key in the amount in ringgit and then it will automatically convert to US dollar at the current and latest exchange rate by the bank. So then there are two ways to transfer money to TradeStation account. We are going to do a foreign telegraphic transfer, or also known as FTT. Or in other words, it's also wire transfer. When making an FTT, there is a service fee of 10 ringgit by Maybank. So if you are satisfied with the amount that you want to transfer, click transfer. Then in the next pop-up, under sender details, your nationality, select Malaysian, then key in your address, postcode, and select Malaysia as country. Then under recipient's bank details, referring to the TradeStation transfer instructions, which you save the information or printed earlier. Here, key in exactly and follow the transfer instructions. The recipient's bank is JP Morgan Chase. The SWIFT code is CHASUS333. The FACT wire or ABA code, which is a 9-digit code, is 021-000-021. Then the account number is 7998-24925. The branch address is 1 Chase Manhattan Plaza, 7th floor. City is New York. Then if you have a Master Foreign Currency account, or also known as MFCA, you can transfer from that account. If not, continue to recipient's details. Here, nationality is non-Malaysian. Name is TradeStation Securities, followed by your account number. And remember, each account has its own account number. Equities has its own account number. Futures account has its own account number. Then business registration number is the IRS employer identification number. You can Google TradeStation business registration number. It is under the SEC website. I'll put the link in the description. Then continuing on, key in the recipient address. It is 8050 SW 10th Street Suite 2000, Plantation FL 33324, country is United States. Then the contact number can also be found on Google and also in the SEC website. Then as for the email, you can leave it blank. Then under transfer details, purpose, select services, sub-purpose, select financial intermediary services, then agent or beneficiary bank's fees, select I will pay, recipient will pay the full sum or amount. This means the foreign bank, or in this case, JP Morgan Chase, charges fees for the transfer. So not only Maybank charges fees, JP Morgan also charges fees for the transfer. Then add additional details, key in your full name as per your account, followed by the account number which you want to transfer the money into. So let's say you want to transfer into your equities account, key in your full name, then followed by your equities account number. Or if you want to transfer to your futures account, key in your full name, and then followed by your futures account number. Then check, I've read the terms and conditions, then click the green transfer button. Then after the transaction has been approved, my advice will be to save this TradeStation security as a favorite. So next time and every time onwards, you don't have to key in all the details again and again for each and every transaction. And you want to save each account as their own favorites. That means to your equities account is one favorite, and then to futures account is another favorite, if you have opted to trade in futures accounts in TradeStation. Then once the fund transfer has been processed by Maybank and confirmed receipt in TradeStation account, you'll receive an email by TradeStation where there's one more thing to do, even though you have already funded your account. So click the link in the email to proceed. You have to fill out the W-8 form, which is for US and international tax reporting purposes. So click, go to the form, which you'll be brought to another window. In this pop-up here, scroll down and click I agree to the end user license agreement. Then in the next page, if you're not familiar with which tax form to fill up, click the start button. It will walk you through some questions to select the correct tax form for your status. However, if you're familiar with tax forms, click here to select your form. So as we see here, there's W-8-B-E-N for non-US individuals, W-8-B-E-N-E for non-US business, and W-8-I-M-Y for intermediary or flow-through entity. And disclaimer here, for accounting and tax advice, please consult a qualified tax accountant and advisor. Anyway, as example here, and to walk you through for the W-8BEN form. Fill in your full name, country of citizenship, permanent residence address, tax identification number, date of birth, then tax treaty and signer details, which is the signer name and capacity for signing. In this case and in this video, I'm signing on my own behalf. For you, after you have filled up all the information and signed the document, click submit. Then for certification purpose, click I agree. Then you can download preview of your W-8BEN form. Then check the checkbox and then click continue. Then sign form. Then you can download the completed and signed W-8BEN form. Then back in your account, you can download the TradeStation platform. This is for Windows. For Mac users, you will still have to use and trade through the browser, like on Chrome and Safari. That means web trading in TradeStation. And this TradeStation platform is on this video's recording. So if you are a Mac user, you can skip to the next part on how to log in for web trading and how to connect TradingView to TradeStation. Anyway, to download the TradeStation platform on Windows, go to download software, and then at TradeStation platform, click continue. So here you'll be asked, are you a professional subscriber? Check yes or no to the questions from A to L, then click continue. For me, I'm going to check yes to all these questions. Then there is this pop-up. If you are a non-professional subscriber, click confirm. Then in the next screen, choose your optional software features and market data. So that's Option Station Pro, Radar Screen, and TradeStation Portfolio Maestro. And as of this video recording, they are free. So to continue, click continue. Then there's also platform features and data services available. Then click continue. We're going to continue. So click continue. Then to sign online agreements, check I agree, type in the date, type in your name, and then click I agree. Then you can download the TradeStation platform on Windows. Now, for web trading and also for Mac users, go to the TradeStation website and click sign in. So you see here in this pop-up, there are a few options. We're going to focus on two. That's Web Trading Live and Web Trading Simulator. Basically, it's paper trading to practice your trading without risking real money. So for live trading, click Login under Web Trading Live. And so here, how it's like in the TradeStation web trading platform. You can play around with the tabs or change the layout. Currently, we are in the live account. You can also go to the simulated trading account. Go to the top right, where now we see live. Click it and change to Sim. So now we are in the Sim trading account. Now, if you're familiar with TradingView, which is a popular charting app, you can also link TradingView to TradeStation. So you can go to the TradingView website, or if you have the TradingView app downloaded on your desktop or app on the mobile or tablet, go to the bottom arrow here, or you can pull up for full screen. Then under Trading Panel, you can also paper trade with TradingView, but we want to connect to TradeStation. So that's the Trading Panel. So there are a few brokerages that you can connect with TradingView. But in this video, we want to connect with TradeStation. So search for TradeStation and then click it. Then you can connect the live account or SIM account. We're going to connect the SIM account. So log in with your TradeStation login and password. And there it is. So easy. TradingView is now connected to your TradeStation and ready for SIM or paper trading. So on TradingView, it's very easy to do a lot of charting. If you like to do a lot of technical analysis and you like to put a lot of charts and indicators to help you in your trading, TradingView is one of, or if not the most popular charting app out there in the industry. So thanks for watching, and I hope you found today's tutorial video on TradeStation helpful. For more contents like this and in real estate, investing, finance, and home products, hit the like button below and subscribe to this channel.